Very good morning to everyone. Myself, Vishal Pandey, and today I'm going to start a new chapter from your civics portion, the Union Legislature, the Parliament. So as you can see on your screen, this chapter will help you to understand the structure of Parliament, which is important body in our legislature or in our democratic conditions or in that structure. Let us go ahead. If you talk about India, as you know that it is a federal republic. It has one level of government at the center, the union government, and one level of government at the state level, that is the state government. So we have union government as well as state government. Union government is also known as center government. The body that governs India at the center, that is India's union legislature, is known as the parliament. So parliament execute at center level, which is situated at New Delhi. The body that governs India at center, that is India's union legislature, is known as the parliament. Don't forget this. It is important. It is the highest law-making body of the country. So parliament is the highest law-making body of the country itself. It consists of Rajya Sabha, Council of States, it can be also called, and the Lok Sabha, House of the People. So Rajya Sabha is known as Council of States, and Lok Sabha is also known as House of the People. Rajya Sabha is also known as Upper House, and Lok Sabha is also known as Lower House. So don't forget this to mention. The members of the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha are called members of Parliament, that is MPs. The Parliament holds its sessions at Sansad Bhavan or Parliament House in New Delhi. So as I told you earlier, that Parliament has been situated at New Delhi, in New Delhi, as you can say. But in that context, you can also call it Sansad Bhavan and Parliament House. So members, those who are elected by people and are responsible to sit in this house, are called members of Parliament, that is MPs. So don't forget to mention that MPs are members of Parliament, from where the question arises. Now in that condition, you should also have a physical view of the Parliament House or Sansad Bhavan. I will be showing you in the next slide. Now you can see, this is the portrait of Sansad Bhavan or Parliament House, which is situated in New Delhi. It is a very fine example of democracy. Okay, so in that condition, let us move toward, and one question arises, that why was the parliament form of government chosen? What was the need to choose parliament at the form of government? Kaise ye government ka part bana? और पार्लियामेंट की रिक्वायरमेंट क्या थी, क्यों ये कंपलसरी था, ऑल द थिंग्स विल बी डिस्कस्ड इन दिस स्लाइड. रिप्रेजेंटेशनल डेमोक्रेसीज कैन आइदर अडॉप्ट अ पार्लियामेंट्री फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट और प्रेसिडेंशियल फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट. एज यू सॉ इन द लास्ट चैप्टर, इंडिया हैज़ अ पार्लियामेंट्री फॉर्म ऑफ गवर्नमेंट. हियर द एग्जीक्यूटिव इज आंसरेबल टू द लेजिस्लेचर. As I told you in the previous chapter, the ideals and the ideas of Indian Constitution, in that chapter you had already understood that India has a parliamentary form of government. It means In India, there is parliament to execute, to make the rules and regulations. So parliament plays an important role in this country. And if you want to emphasize it on more in that condition, you should understand the houses, the different houses. As I told you, that Rajya Sabha is equivalent to Council of States and Lok Sabha is equivalent to House of the People. So in that condition, you must be knowing this, that executive is answerable to the legislature. What it means? That whoever is appointed to perform the action, they will be answerable to legislature. So they have to report to legislature, they have to report to parliament. In that condition, in a presidential form of government, the head of state, that is the president, is directly elected by the people and hence wields great power. As you can see in the United States of America, in that condition, the president of America is directly elected by people. That is why in that country, the form of government is presidential form of government. But in India, it is parliamentary form of government. The president heads the executive and the executive is not answerable to the legislature. Okay. So the makers of the constitution choose the parliamentary form of government after a lot of thought. It was felt that a presidential form of government would give too much power in the hands of a single individual. When the leaders were making constitution, they thought that if we give the power in one hand, that is the president himself, he or she can misuse it. So it would be better to give the power to legislature, to parliament, rather than giving the power to presidents. So in that condition, in India, the power was given to parliamentary form of government, because in parliament there are certain 545 members, or we can say MPs, member of parliament, along with prime minister. They will decide on a law, on a resolution, and according to them, they will pass it from Lok Sabha and then Rajya Sabha, and then it will be sent to president to do sign, and then it will become a law. So in that condition, it is a systematic form from where a law will travel. Ek system hai, us system se guzar kar ek law, ek kanun banta hai. So in that condition, in India, people thought that parliamentary form of government would be better. It will help a lot to run the country. So let us understand now the importance of Lok Sabha. The Lok Sabha is known as the House of People because its members are directly elected by the people. Now, Lok Sabha's election were held in 2019, where PM Narendra Modi became again Prime Minister of India. So Lok Sabha elections means what? The elections of Prime Minister. In that conditions, MPs are elected, members of parliaments are elected, and there are 545 seats of members of parliament in Lok Sabha. So Lok Sabha elections are very important in India. Currently there are 545 members in the Lok Sabha, and maximum it can be 552. Don't forget to mention that. This number increases as the population of the country grows. So in that condition, if India increases its population, if people are, you know, increasing day by day, in that condition, these numbers can be also increased. increase. So you have to keep this in your mind that we have 552 members, but currently there are 545 members of parliament. So I hope you understood. Watch this video as many times as you can. Take care. Bye-bye.